Hey guys, it's Here Comes Charlie. Hope you're doing well. I'm taking an online course and I've been studying all day and I am done. So I thought that I would just rattle off a quick video. I acquired a new pipe and I'm quite excited about it, so I thought we might have a look. So I have it in the workroom just because the light's a little better, so let's go do that. So let's get right to it. Here it is, it's a Dunhill. This is my first Dunhill, and my dad found it. He lives in the States, and I asked him to keep an eye out for interesting pipes, and so here it is. This is an egg shape. I can't, trying to see where I can get a good shot of the grain. Yeah, sorry about the focus. I'm going to try to get in tight on it. But, so here's what I managed to find out about it so far. I've never found this shape. I haven't been able to find this shape on any of the Dunhill guides, but I believe that's an egg shape. It's a group 5. The markings on the pipe, but it's got a 5 with a circle under it. That's the group size. And then beside that, just to the right, it says Dunhill Briar. On the other side, it says Made in England. And then a postscript, the number 32, which is underlined. So it's in the sort of little equation that they use is 1960 plus that number. It gives you the year of the pipe. So that would date this pipe at 1992. Generally in very good shape. The bowl is fantastic. The finish is good. It's slightly dull, but I'm going to buff it up. There's one shiny spot there, right? Sort of right about there. It's very shiny, and the rest is quite dull, so I think it just needs a little buff with some wax, and it'll come back beautifully. And the stem is generally in very good shape. It's mostly black, a little bit of gray starting right around here, but all in all, it's pretty good. I think it could use a very mild or short bleach time and a buff. It'll come back really nicely. Hoping I can do that without any mishaps. I've had a little bit of practice now, so I think it'll come back just beautifully, but it almost doesn't need attention, but I think I'm going to do it just to get it right up to, you know, primo. So so that's it. Dunhill Man UK, I've really been enjoying your videos, and actually your video on your Dunhill is what sort of propelled me to do this one, so I thought that I'd make that my next video. When I got this pipe, somebody definitely has smoked a Latakia in it, and the ghost flavor on the pipe was unbelievable. I'm about 50-50 between aromatics and English, maybe a little more on the English lately, but I've only tried a few and I don't smoke that often, so I haven't tried a whole ton of tobaccos, but I've tried this Solani English, which I quite like. I did a quick little video on that a while back, and I don't know what was in this pipe, but it is awesome. It's unbelievable. It's definitely strong Latakia, but it's almost got like a perfumey taste. I don't know what it is, but I would love to know what the person smoked in this pipe, because the ghost that comes from it is just fantastic. So anyway, I'm open to Latakia recommendations, and I'd be interested to know if you want to leave me a comment what your, you know, if you had one desert island English tobacco that you had to take with you, what would it be? I'd be very interested in that. So yeah, that's it. That's my new, I guess I'm a Dunhill owner now, so I didn't think that it would be in the budget for me, but it's a lovely pipe, and I'm happy to have it. And just a real quick shout out, guys, some of your videos are just awesome, and I really, really appreciate the effort that you're putting into posting. I start every day by checking out the YouTube videos for pipe stuff, so Requiem Pipes, Gustavo, I really enjoyed your comment on the tobacco industry, very interesting post. What else? Lataki Yen's really digging your stuff. Dunhill Man UK, your stuff's lots of fun. Hope your pipe bag is working out for you, buddy. And that's it. So all thanks, you guys. I don't think I'll post anything else between now and Christmas. So I'll say to Milverton, a pat on the head to Nico for me, and have a wonderful Christmas, you guys. Best of the season to you. And that's it. So peace out and best regards. See ya. Sometimes I wish that I could stop you from talking when I hear the silly things that you say.
Somebody better put out the big light, 'cause I can't stand to see.